Welcome to the archersfriend.com movie slideshow on my trophy bull moose hunt of 2006. For years, we've been trying to get a bull moose. We have extraordinarily good luck finding them. We just haven't been able to get a tag. In 2003, we bought a digital camera to record some of our findings. And as you'll see, we seem to have no trouble finding moose. A lot of young ones, but as you'll see later, a lot of good ones too. In 2003, a buddy of mine drew a cow moose tag, and after our archery hunt, I came back to town and went with him to help him get his cow moose that he couldn't find. Just a little ways up the mountain out of Salt Lake City, Utah, it's a beautiful area of public ground available. So that's where his tag was, so that's where we went. Went up there, 4 hours later, we had him a nice moose. This is some of the scenery in that country in late October. Took me about 2 hours to find this gorgeous bull and three or four cows that he had. You can see the little dark spots out in the bushes. He wasn't very impressed with us, but we were able to isolate one of his herd cows and take the animal. The bull continued to circle around and annoy us. Of course, I think he was pretty annoyed at us too. This bull is one of the best bulls I've ever seen in my life. He rivals a lot of Alaskan bulls, as you can see by his spread. But we were successful in getting a cow and getting it into the back of the fellow's truck. And I was just jealous that he'd gotten a tag. I still hadn't drawn anything. The cows are once every 5 years. The bulls are once in a lifetime. Years and years of putting in, and finally, as if by magic, in 2006, I drew a tag. We are constantly scouting during the archery hunt for elk and deer and looking for moose. The area we hunt has a very good population and some very good animals. As you can see, the country is vast. The elevation is 7,500 to 8,500 feet. There's a nice bull below that pine there. The time was, the year was late September when the tag comes into play. During the archery hunt, I saw several of these animals and photographed them. Some big bulls, these are two twins, probably saw 25 bulls. The big ones just didn't want to let me get close enough to get really close pictures, but we do have some nice close-up pictures. This one's about 20 yards out, and we had a couple of three 8x8s, 8x9s, 9x9s. This is one of them that I could get within less than 100 yards of and take pictures. Would have been quite a trophy for an archer. Still not what I wanted to shoot with a rifle. This one, during the archery hunt, at about 10 yards out. He didn't seem to mind me being there, or didn't know I was there, and this one is about 10 feet out, believe it or not. I had made my mind up to try to take this animal with my longbow, but as things would have it, tag came good. 4 days of snow, ice, sleet, and rain. We were stuck in camp. On the fourth day, we went out to the mountains and scouted around, got up very high, and noticed a black spot across a canyon, and there are no black rocks in that canyon. So went to get a closer look, and moose took off. I could tell by the rack that this bull was a taker, so I headed down the mountain to intercept him at the canyon confluence of the trail, set up my ambush, and waited while friends stayed up high to keep him from escaping over the ridge. And as you can see, almost to the top, he came through a 50-foot opening, and although way out of range of a bow, my 300 reached out and touched him. So now that we had a bull on the ground well over 1,000 pounds, how do you get it home? Well, fortunately, planning led to knowing where he was going to cross, and I was able to get about 10 or 12 tow straps stretched out and my winch cable. And after about 3 hours of work, moving brush, sage, limbs, and whatnot, we were successful in getting him down to the mountain. And then with the help of a hoist on my trailer, we were able to get the animal onto my trailer and get him into camp. All said and done, from the time he went down to the time we got back to camp was probably about 5.5 to 6 hours. Way too late to take him into the processor, so the next morning I took off for town. We wrapped his nose with a tarp to keep from tearing up his face coming through the sagebrush. Here he is in the processor's shop. People from all over came, and 20-something years of processing meat, these people have never seen an elk this nice. It took four of us to get him through the door because his rack didn't want to fit. Well, it's the end of a dream come true. Was able to fill a once-in-a-lifetime tag, and I think that I used it wisely. I just can't say enough about how important it is to know your area and scout. Here's the cape after we've got it ready to go to the taxidermist, and the grandkids are just about as happy as Grandpa about it. Scout your area. Keep putting in for those tags. You never know when you're going to draw out. And if you know your area, then you're prepared to go get your animal. It just don't get any better than this. Check out our website. We have a lot of useful information. Hopefully we can help you get one of your lifetime goals. We'll see you in the mountains someday, and we'll be making more and more videos. Mm-hmm.